full review of the Crest 3D Whitening Strips, specifically the 1 Hour Express.
Oh, hi, Marc.
So not wasting any time.
So I'm gonna pull back my lip. So you can see like everything. Do that.
I actually did take a before and after picture, but the problem was I took the before picture at my friend's place and the lighting was completely different. So it's one thing I didn't even think about, because when I took the after picture and I compared them, I was like, wait, my teeth definitely got significantly whiter, but because the lighting looked differently, you couldn't really tell that well. So I was like, you know what? I'm also going to show you on camera the finished product. Here is basically like a whitening scale. I will say it went up by at least a few shades. It was amazing just after doing this for 1 week, and also going to talk about my whole experience, how much whiter my teeth gotten, even to the point where I had some friends being like, wow, your teeth look really good. And I'm like, yeah, the whitening strips work, right? And I want to say I have no affiliation with Crest. They did not ask me to make this video. I was just very curious because obviously everybody wants white teeth. And I talked to some of my friends who are dentists, and I said, hey, is there any legitimate way to whiten your teeth? Like, what's the best, honest way? And they're like, look, whitening strips are the way to go. Crest 3D are basically the best ones you can get. Just pick these up and use them. Now, for me personally, I am not gonna lie, whitening strips are so frustrating to use, but they work. So there's also like a pros and a cons thing. For most whitening strip packages you see, it's usually like a bunch of them. You either have it on anywhere from about like 15 or maybe even 30 minutes all the way up into an hour. I'd much rather have to do it 7 times for 1 hour, and then I'm done, and then I do it in the future whenever I wanna do it again, as opposed to, I've seen something like 14 days where you wear it for 30 minutes every day for 14 days straight. I just feel like that's too lengthy, so that's why I like the 1 hour express a lot better. Now, there's a few things I did to basically optimize my teeth, if that's the right word, to get as white as possible. So first off, do not brush when using these. That was super counterintuitive to me. I actually thought you always brush and then put on the whitening strips. I guess you're better off not doing that. So let's say if you had just brushed your teeth, wait about 2 to 3 hours and then put these on. I find that also it makes it a lot easier to put them on, because like a lot of people, and this is super frustrating about these, my mouth salivates tremendously when I use whitening strips. So my strategy basically is obviously, again, 3 hours-ish roughly after I've brushed my teeth, or let's say if I wake up, I purposely don't brush my teeth in the morning, then I put on the whitening strips, you know, maybe an hour or two after I wake up, and then I brush my teeth afterwards. So what I do is I always start with the bottom strip, because I found that right when I put one of the strips on, I instantly start salivating. It's just incredibly annoying. So at least with the bottom one, that's usually the trickier one. Make sure it's perfectly in position, and then obviously fold it over and tighten it, and then put the top one on and then tighten that as well. I'd set an alarm on my phone for basically 1 hour, and then at that point, I'd be pretty much good to go. Now, a couple of negative things I will say is that I read that actually when you're doing the whitening strips, for up to 48 to 72 hours after you use them, your teeth are actually more sensitive and more prone to being stained. So I avoided coffee, wine, berries, tea. Basically for this entire week, I basically avoided anything that could potentially stain my teeth even more so. I don't know exactly how it works in terms of how much more I could stain if I did have coffee, for example. But I was like, you know what? Murphy's Law. In addition, I did have some slight sensitivity when using these. Obviously, that's the biggest kind of unfortunate con of using whitening strips, besides the salivation, which is super frustrating, is the sensitivity. I'd say for me, my teeth almost got more used to it. Even now, filming this video, they're still a slight bit sensitive, and I know eventually it will go away. But there were, I think it was like the second or third day, there was a point where I was just doing something normally. I wasn't even eating. I was just, you know, going about my day. And all of a sudden, I got this painfully sharp, and we all know that horrible feeling, this like painfully sharp feeling in my teeth out of nowhere, like it was being stabbed. And I was like, what is going on? And it went away after maybe like 30 seconds. But I remember thinking like, oh my God, it's only like day 2 or day 3. That only happened to me once. But obviously, if you do have very sensitive teeth, especially with like something super hot, and especially something super cold, get some Sensodyne. Basically just have that during this week while you're using it, so that way at least with your teeth, you don't get that super sensitive feeling, which can be super frustrating and super annoying. But besides that, these really did work. It was amazing how much whiter my teeth got, especially using the 1 hour express. Like I said, I do it 7 times, it's 7 hours. I'm not gonna lie, just being honest, that hour crawls by. Like one thing I did that I noticed too, I read this, is that if you're just sitting there just waiting for the hour, you almost salivate more, because I think like you're thinking about something in your mouth. So what I would actually do is I would actually produce music. I'm a DJ and electronic music producer, in case you didn't know. So I found that if I was working on music, I found that I actually salivated less, because I wasn't fully concentrating on this like whitening strip in my mouth and just being like, oh, I just want this hour to be up and just waiting for it. At least I was doing something that kind of occupied my mind. And also too, it made the time fly by. So by the time, you know, like I said, I was in the zone working on music, by the time it was over, I was like, oh, wow. All right, guess I'm all done for today. I'm gonna do it the next day, so on and so forth. So they definitely work, and they work incredibly well. I mean, if you think about it, it is kind of a simple thing. You just put on the whitening strip and wait an hour. But with the cons, definitely super annoying with the sensitivity. Wasn't too bad for me, but I know some people have had some very, very just negative reactions when it comes to the sensitivity when using a whitening strip. And two, just the salivation was annoying. If you wanna be honest on camera, I'm always super transparent and blunt. What I actually did, I felt so awkward doing this, is I would salivate so much, I literally have a cup. And if I would salivate too much after, let's say, 5 or 10 minutes, I'd literally spit into a cup. I know it's gross, I know it's super annoying, but that was the only thing I could do because I was like, okay, I'm salivating way too much. And I thought maybe it would get easier throughout the week because I read that, like, oh, your mouth will eventually get used to it. It didn't for me. My mouth still, every time, even day 6, even day 7, the last final day, my mouth is salivating incredibly. I'm like, great, I just have a cup next to me, making music, kind of low-key spitting in a cup every 5 or 10 minutes. I know it's gross, but that's what I had to do. But hey, at the end of the day, got whiter teeth. That's what matters. So besides the cons, which were definitely annoying, the Crest 3D whitening strips work amazingly.